I told you she is very, very interesting. Yeah. Karibu sana.
Thank you, baby girl.
Nice.
If you didn't catch it, I told you the last week when I called her for this interview, she didn't know who I was. So I called her and she told me, "Hello, baby girl." And I literally looked at my phone. I was like, "Did I call the wrong number?" Mm-hmm. You know? So why did you call me baby girl?
Because one thing I know, yes, all girls, to your mother, you are a baby forever. And when she got you, she said, yeah, God has blessed me with a baby girl. So forever you'll be a baby girl to your mother.
Okay.
No matter how old you are.
Regardless of age.
Yes, it's not a matter of age. You are forever a baby girl. Even when I'll be 50, I'll still be my mother's baby girl.
I felt so nice. To be honest, it strung the right chords. Yeah. I felt so good.
We have to keep ourselves going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So welcome to the show. That's DJ Kroba.
Hello.
Hi.
So welcome to the show. Tell us, introduce yourself to our viewers. Who is Monica? And then we'll pick it up from there.
Oh, my name's Monica Owoche Elias. Mm-hmm. I work for Serena.
Yeah.
I fellowship at Satan Buruburu, where we keep it Christ.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Are you married? Do you have a family?
Yes, I'm married to Elias. We are blessed with two girls, mm-hmm, Beth, who is 23, mm-hmm, in campus, and Hope, who is 7. She just turned 7, mm-hmm, a gap of 15 years.
Wait, so there's 23-year-old Beth, yes, and 7-year-old Hope.
Yes.
Okay, there's a 15-year gap in the middle. Tell us about that, because I know you wanted to share about that as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The 15 years, you know, sometimes growing up, okay, as a young girl growing up, I was brought up in the ways of the Lord. I loved the Lord. And personally, I knew by the time I reach 30, no more giving birth. I knew I would end 20s there. And by God's grace, I got married at a very nice age, early 20s.
Oh, you got married at early 20s?
Yes. Uh-huh. Beth came in immediately. And then after that, you start wondering, what's happening? What's happening?
You're not conceiving.
You're not conceiving. Your husband has not gone on leave. You're forever together. Then you realize, wait, something is happening here. Then because you know you are a person, I love praying. Prayer is my passion. I pray, pray, pray. I say pray until you die.
Mm. Pray until you die. That's
nice. As you breathe your last breath, breathe praying.
Mm.
So I started praying about it, praying about it. Those days, I was brought up in Corino.
Ulukuwa Mkorino?
Oh, yes. The new ones are called Roho, so we were Roho. That is my background.
Okay, tell us about that. Now you've gotten his address.
Okay,
wow.
Yes.
Which is the lower version of
Corino.
Of Corino.
Yeah, because most people know Corino is known like worldwide.
Uh-huh.
Roho is a bit not really known.
Uh-huh. Ni wagani. This kind
of wanaweka musalaba hapa, uh-huh, na kitamba.
Yes.
Na kuna bakala.
White. Purple. Robe, white robe.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. And then you have a white scarf, uh-huh, with a musalaba.
So it's white. The ones who wear purple, those are Legio Marias, I think.
Legio Maria.
Uh-huh.
But even Roho, they're different sects. So ours was called, my father's is called Roho Teacher Beach. They fellowship on Fridays.
Okay.
Yes. So that's where I was brought up.
Mm.
So we start praying, trusting God. And my father was a real intercessor, because he went to be with the Lord last year.
Mm.
So I decided to go and share with him. Something is happening.
But in the Roho, do they believe in Jesus and salvation? And tell us about
that. They believe in Jesus, but there's some disconnect.
There is.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So when did you make the reconnection?
To move.
Yeah.
Monica has a story, but God is faithful. What made me move? How I moved? That's back now in 2003.
Mm.
I had an issue in an office, a challenge, which had been going on. Then another time now it exploded. So the challenge, one of my colleagues abused me.
Mm.
You know, I loved God, I had a passion. And in Roho Musalaba, you walk with your plate, you walk with your cup. So me in the office, Insere, those are some of their beliefs.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes. So
you
I used even to
Serena.
Her. Me in Serena, I had my cup and it had a musalaba.
Okay.
And I was not embarrassed. I had a passion for my God. Wow. You know, teach a child the way.
And they will never depart from me.
It takes God. It does take God.
Okay. So how old are you at this time? You're working, you've been Roho for years.
For my life,
So you're now working at Serena. Are you wearing normal clothes?
I'm wearing normal clothes, but once in a while I carry, especially the days you are in prayer, I carry a kitamba with a musalaba. When I leave the gate, I tie it.
Where? Kroba. Wow.
So that tells you what God can do. He can fish you. It doesn't matter where you are. He looks at the heart. I say, I have a burden for those people because I've been there. And I say, there's a reason why the Lord fished me. I am the ambassador. I need to keep them in prayer that the God who fished me.
So how are you, how did you reconnect?
Somebody insulted me in an office. And what he said, and you are a devil worshiper. That just, she said many things, but that alone made me cry. I cried. I started telling God, Jehovah God, my dad brought me up knowing that I'm serving you. He had been told I'm a devil worshiper. Is there another God apart from the one my father introduced me to? And I started praying. I started searching for God. I started asking God, Lord, do not leave me. I don't want to go to hell. I want to live with you when my work on earth will be over. And by, I started dreaming. The Lord speaks to me a lot in dreams.
You're a dreamer.
Yes, I'm a dreamer. That's why I even saw that tag. That's also a dream I have. So I started dreaming, and he started guiding me. Then one day, the turning point, I didn't know where to go. So I dreamt that I was walking, looking for a church. I landed in Nairobi Baptist, this one Ngong Road.
Palikulikona concert.
Yes. When I entered inside, there was worship going on. I didn't like the worship. So I walked out in the dream. So I continued walking. Then I landed in Sitam Valley Road. Then there was worship going on. I loved the worship. I worshipped in my dream. Then I woke up. So when I woke up, I knew this is where the Lord wanted me to be. So that's how I switched.
So yes. God spoke to you through a dream.
God spoke to me through a dream. And also, you know, in fact, that was now, I think, the fourth time I was leaving. The forces, they are not easy. I was leaving and going back,
But we need to clarify, there's nothing wrong with Nairobi Baptist Church.
It's just
a wonderful church. Your dream,
yes,
God led you that way.
Yes, it's just that, you see, we are all one body of Christ, scattered all over the world. We can't fit in the same church. Some are in Anglican. We are all God's people. But for me, it's only that the Lord wanted me to be there for a reason, for a purpose that Him alone knows. There's nothing wrong.
So you now joined Sitam?
Yes.
And that's where you've been serving?
That's where I've been serving.
Yes. How many years now?
It's going like almost 10.
Almost 10 years.
Yes.
So you left Roho kabisa kabisa?
Completely.
What did your family say?
My family, and in fact when I left, the whole sect was shaken up. They couldn't believe. I was a staunch believer. Our church is in Kariobangi. They're still, the brethren are still there. So every Friday they kesha, we pray. Those people pray. They search the Lord. May the Lord open their inner eyes. So my family, my dad was my great supporter. But my family members, others of them were ish. It didn't knit well. Even to date, it's not really knitted well, accepted, because it's the family church. This is a family, we were very poor, and this is the God our father introduced us to, and we've seen the Lord move with Mzee, the Lord help him educate us. So to them, what are you telling us? But I keep them in prayer. But you apparently prayer. One of my brothers now is a pastor, surprisingly. I led him to the Lord.
Wow.
You know, like the 15 years.
Yes.
He knew my struggle. He knew how I was dedicated. And when he heard Monica got another baby, so he traveled to come and see Monica's baby. He was amazed. So he told me, my sister, you've discovered a God who has opened your womb again. I'm going to help you, walk with you, and serve with you. So he told me, lead me to Christ.
Wow. So let me get this straight before we go on a music break. Eh? So the Lord used the barrenness. Is that right? Did he use the barrenness of those few years of not having a baby to draw you close to him?
Or to draw me close to God.
Or to open your eyes. Because that's a time in the middle when you are searching God, right? Amma.
Okay, basically, the barrenness, even when I left there, it was part and parcel of me. Yes, it was still part and parcel of me. But now, when I came here, I told the Lord, that is a prayer I used to pray. Jehovah God, now, I was told I was a devil worshiper. Do for me something that will make even my family know that indeed I've discovered you. And I presented that. Jehovah, you know, we prayed with my dad until he cried, nothing happened. Won't you do open my womb? That they may see. You know, signs and wonders move some people. Like my family, I'm telling you.
They have to
I know
miracles.
It's all because they've seen the things God has done in their family. So unless they see signs and wonders. So I presented that to God and kept praying. Jehovah, and even my dad, because he prayed and cried.
So nothing happened.
Nothing happened.
Wow.
So the Lord did that. So yes, that made a great big breakthrough, even drew me very close to my dad. And now our family, but they even today.
Now the miracle of baby hope.
The miracle baby hope. So even my family today, they know there are two gods. The God of Monica and the God of our father. Yes. So the God of Monica is Monica and my brother Peter, who is a pastor.
Yeah.
The God of our father is for the rest of the family.
Okay.
Yes.
That's an interesting dynamic. But we'll go to the music. When we come back, we'll go now to the meat of this testimony. And something terrible happened in Monica's life. We want to see how God delivered her from that situation.
Amen.
Right, Kroba? Me, that's the one I want to hear.
You want to hear the testimony.
That's the one.
I want to play a song. It's known as Wasud Nyime by Emma Omonge. You're going to love this one.
Amen.